My attention was caught by the phrase, "Shake the dust from your feet in testimony against them." To relate that or try to find meaning through human experience in the modern world, yung pag-shake ng dust sa ating paa ay maiintindihan natin, especially now that we are most careful about this unseen virus. Whenever we enter establishments, there is a, hindi nga rag, a foot bath, not just for people but even for cars. They sanitize the feet, thinking that the feet may have brushed unwanted elements para hindi na maipasok sa pupuntahan o papasukang lugar. So that much we understand, to prevent dust from coming in, to prevent unwanted elements from the shoes from being brought in, we have a foot rug or foot bath. But the opposite seems to be present in the gospel. Jesus did not advise his apostles to shake the dust before entering the village. The advice is that whenever you get rejected, whenever you have a negative experience, before you go out, you shake the dust off your feet. Papalabas. No establishment now will have a foot bath. Going out of the establishment, it is always present. Going in the establishment. What does Jesus mean when he reverses this hygienic process? Maybe it is not viruses or physical elements that Jesus wants to shake off the disciples. Being a preacher himself and being rejected himself, Jesus knows the uneasy feeling of someone who has been rejected or wronged. And if the disciples get rejected in one village and they feel anger and they feel dejected and they have negative feelings, will it not be unfair and tragic to bring these negative feelings, to bring this anger to the next town na wala pa namang ginagawang kasamaan sa kanila, na wala pa namang pinapakitang rejection sa kanila? If the disciples do not shake off the negative feelings, the anger, the hatred, the feeling that they want to do revenge in that town, then the preaching of the gospel will eventually be a disastrous process for the church. Halimbawa, gumising ng umaga, kinain ng daga yung ulam, galit na galit, paglabas ng bahay, pagbabayad sa konduktor, pagagalitan yung konduktor, kawawa naman, walang kamalay-malay, bakit ka nagagalit ang aga-aga ng umaga? Pagdating sa opisina, pagagalitan ng lahat ng taong makikita doon. Pagdating sa lunch break, pagagalitan lahat ang makikita. At pagbalik, hindi mo na makikita yung daga na pinagalitan mo, pero galit ka pa rin. Bakit nasira ang araw mo? Dahil kinain ng daga ang ulam kaninang umaga. And there is a ripple effect to people you love, to people who you work with, to people whom you communicate with. I believe, dear brothers and sisters, Jesus gives a very, very practical wisdom and advice to his disciples. Have a moment to shake off the anger. Have a moment to shake off the dust. Have a moment to shake off the negative feelings, because the next person you meet does not deserve the anger that you have from the former experience. To proclaim the good news is to proclaim Jesus. It's not to proclaim our anger, it's not to proclaim our negativity, it's not to proclaim unfortunate events. It's a proclamation of the good news. And that continues to be and will always be the vocation in which we have full participation. Let us all stand.